Okay, so before we get started on repotting the tree, what we need to do is to get all the tools prepared, everything that we might need, and have it pat to hand. Okay, so I've got two different types of scissors. These are very good for root pruning, as you'll see. This is just a normal pair of scissors, very cheap. Rubber mallet, disposable sort of chopsticks. This is a bit of a thicker, stronger bamboo chopstick. Three-pronged root hook. This is quite an aggressive tool, but it is useful if used correctly. Root hook for getting out, for helping to get the tree out of the pot. Now this is blunt at the end, out of years of use, so we can't focus on that one anyway. And then suitable gauge thickness wire for tying down in the pot. Some scrap wire for making the tie downs for the mesh is there, and then a brush. The other thing to do is to prepare the soil. Okay, so here we have some ready-made soil. This is a mixture of one part Akadama, one part pumice, one part lava, and one part kiddo, which is pretty much my fundamental conifer mix. What you'll notice is there's quite a bit of dust in here, and we're going to take that out before we put it into the pot. But all the particle sizes are pretty much the same. So the lava, the pumice, the Akadama, the kiddo, they're all exactly the same size. It's very, very important. Okay, but it definitely needs to be sieved before we put it in to get rid of all the dust. So, first job is to get the tree out of the pot. Okay, so what we're going to do is take off the wire underneath. Okay, now this tree's been in this pot for a good couple of years. I've definitely had it for 2 years. But it hasn't grown tremendously, so it's not going to be absolutely sort of jam-packed in there. It should be relatively easy to get out. Sometimes what you might need to do is to just take the wires that are holding the mesh in, particularly if the tree's kind of like growing into the mesh, it might be difficult to remove it if that's still intact. So, carefully just go around the edge, so it's coming away very easily, so it's not been in here for too long. Okay, just carefully go around. Always try and do it so your hands are out of the way. Okay, try and scratch the surface of the pot. Okay, so don't put your hand there and come into it, because you're going to hurt yourself. Okay. And the objective is not to try and get through, tear it out too much, just to kind of remove as much of the soil as you possibly can. Okay. Look at that. See, that's really easy. That's coming out nicely. So I didn't even really need to do that. It's just to sort of show you. So, first things first, let's inspect the root ball. Okay, look for any signs of damage. Okay, we've got some tips, root tips there that are growing. Okay, there's no signs of any damage anywhere. Okay, no signs of any root death. There's no funky smell. Okay, so there's no areas of concern. Okay, so what we need to do is think about how and what we're going to pot this in. Okay, it's been planted right in the centre of this pot up until now. Okay, so it's been really boring. Okay, what we're going to do is accentuate the movement of the tree across towards the left-hand side. So we're going to want to plant it off-center in a pot towards the right. So we'll definitely be looking at removing some of the root ball here, and also looking at removing some of the width. Okay, so it's very wide on both sides. So we're going to be working on the root ball here and here. Okay. So you notice I've got this playground rubber matting on the floor, so it's easy on the knees. Okay, I keep a dustbin here in between there, saves on tidying up. Okay, so just very carefully with the root hook, just pull out. Okay, if you are applying too much force, tearing the roots is a bad thing. Okay. But it's perfectly kind of like okay to just go through lightly like this. Okay. Now the soil on this is very, very wet, so it has a tendency to clump together. It's not a good idea to let the tree out, to the tree dry out before you repot it. I know some people do, I've never really understood why. It doesn't make it any easier. Okay. We're going to be cutting the roots back quite hard on this tree. It's been allowed to grow quite freely for a couple of years in order to build up some strength. So we can be relatively aggressive with it. But we don't want to be too aggressive with the root hook. This is just a light once around on the surface for this tree. So the main objective for this repot is to try and build up a slightly smaller root ball. It's nice and solid in there. It's had a lot of root growth, but just try to reduce it down a little bit and also get it into a much more kind of suitable, aesthetically pleasing pot if we can. Okay, so going around once more. Got to get the scissors out in a minute. So I just went quickly around the root ball there, just to reduce it down in size a little bit more. Okay, still not touched the bottom yet. There we go. So we'll just have a little bit of a work on that. So this tree had been massively overpotted previously. Not by myself, it was like that when I purchased it, but as I said, it was weak when it was purchased and it's just been allowed to kind of grow out and get a bit more strength back into it. And what we'll also do is remove a little bit of the growth on top to give it a bit of a style as well. Okay, but we don't want to be going too aggressively into the bottom, okay? Taking a little bit off. Right, so the previous wires in there. Okay, what we don't want to do is tear it out, yank it, put too much pressure on it. Okay, if it pops out nice and easily, all good. Okay. You see, there's been a lot of sphagnum moss in here. I don't know if you can see that in there. Okay, previously, and what we need to do is we need to get that out. So if that stays in there for too long, it's going to rot, cause some problems with drainage, or the passage of water through the pot. And so we need to get rid of that. Actually, I had forgotten one tool. A pair of tweezers is very good for this, so I've just got to get that and bring the air. Okay, so a pair of tweezers, very useful for working on the soil surface like this as well, particularly the bent angled ones that I tend to use. Just got to go, yeah, I have to be careful not to be too aggressive because it is metal, so particularly around the base of the trunk, got to be careful. Okay. So you can sort of start to see here the Navari beginning to be exposed. Okay, just kept checking the surface roots. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to use some compressed air to clean off some of the surface. Now normally I wouldn't care too much, but the camera's around, I'm going to have to be a bit careful here. So. So I use compressor quite a bit for repotting, for a lot of bonsai work. It's very good. A lot of people think that it might be damaging for the roots in terms of drying it out. Now these have been, this is very, very wet. There's a lot of water in the soil, in the roots. and a short burst from a compressor won't dry the roots out to the point where they would actually get damaged. One very well-known Japanese bonsai professional used a compressor quite a lot for his repotting of Zuisha white pine and also for maples as well. So I've still got a lot of sphagnum moss in here. I've got a lot of put on the soil surface, got to get rid of that. Okay. But speed is very important rather than putting a lot of effort in. So I'm not putting a lot of pressure in, I'm not trying to tear everything out. But I am doing it at high repetition. So. Get that wrist action going. Okay, so we needed to reduce this root ball down quite a bit, so we can just look at taking some of that soil off. Okay. Now we're getting to a point where the root ball is getting roughly to where we kind of want it to be. Any smaller than that, we might start looking at damaging the tree. Okay, but we need to imagine that this mass of foliage, we need a similar kind of volume, mass of roots in order to support it. There was a little bit of blackness in there, which has been caused by the sphagnum moss. Because what happens in that sphagnum is that the roots will grow into it, and potentially if they die off and it gets a big kind of matted mess of dead roots and sphagnum and all just kind of decays and it ends up rotting away, which we don't want. So we've got to make sure we get rid of some of that, so all that stuff on the surface. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to have some paint in the background, but I always find it a lot easier to work on music. Pauses if you don't like the sound, but. Okay, so we are really just sort of mainly concerned with what's going on the soil surface, particularly around the trunk. There's a lot of compacted soil around the trunk. Not seeing any sort of surface roots on this side just yet. Clearly the previous repot just piled up a lot of soil and sphagnum moss around. There's not much libari to speak of on the right hand side of the tree, assuming that this is the front. So perhaps we might need to just have a little bit of a rethink about the styling. Okay, I'm starting to get to the point now where I'm getting a little bit concerned with how much soil I'm taking off, how much I'm going into the sort of the heart of the root ball. Although it's still quite a young tree. The conifers never want to go too hard into that core if you can help it, especially if the tree's healthy and growing well, which this has been. Just want to get rid of any of the bad areas that have had too much sphagnum in them. Okay. So here we go with just clean up that little bit there. So as you can see, there's hardly any sort of surface roots along this side. Don't even know how far they go down there. So, but we have a lot on this side. So I'm wondering if we could utilize those roots here and make a tree which goes across towards the right-hand side instead. Good solid surface roots there. So is there any chance of doing anything like this? Could we stick it on a rock? The problem is the strength of this main trunk line going in there.
Okay, could we come in and remove that? No, not from there, not really worthwhile. Similarly. We could look at reducing it down to there, making use of those roots across that side. But I think that would be a waste. Okay, so rather let's try and perhaps tweak it around that side, or we could even just maybe put a small rock in there or just pile up the soil again just to try and hide that area like it was before. Okay, so rather than going like this, that was my original thought. Okay, let's shorten this side, plant it on the left hand side of the container, and have it moving across the right. Okay, perhaps with an ever so slight inclination. Okay, so let's just tidy up the root ball again, just give it a bit of a trim. Okay. It's important that these scissors are really quite sharp. The sharper the cut, the cleaner the... Fuck! Sorry. Oh, that's not coming up. Should have worn some gloves. What was I saying? Oh yeah, the wound on my hand. The wounds on the roots. If the scissors are sharp and they cut through quite nice and cleanly, then it'll be really, it'll cut. The new roots will come out a lot easier, a lot quicker. If you kind of like cut through and cause like some damage like this, you can see that, where it's just all kind of like torn at the end by kind of like cutting through and tearing at the same time, like that, you know, then it's not gonna, the success rate of the new roots is gonna be a lot less. So just try and cut through nice and sharply, nice good sound, chocky, 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 as they say in Japan. Okay. That should be about enough. Give it one more blow. That's the tune. Okay, stop, 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 stop. Is that a root coming out there? No, there is. Maybe one day. Okay, so let's go and find an interesting pot for this.
So here are some of the pot choices. This is a stone monkey glazed. This is a Yamaki deep pot. It's a little bit too strong. Here's another Yamaki. This is an oval one with a band. Again, a little bit too strong. This is a Namban. This one's looking nice. This is an antique Chinese, which is a little bit too expensive for the tree and also a bit too expansive. This is a Nendosai oval, which is also very lovely.
To just take photographs of them and just go through. You see things differently in a photograph than you do in real life. It just has a slightly different feel to it. And so I think it's a toss-up between one of those two. Kind of leaning towards the Namban there rather than that one. I just feel like kind of a big empty space.
Okay, so I've decided on the Namban. There's no holes in the bottom for the wire, or there's no space for the wire, it's going to be a bit of a pain. Okay, so what we're going to look at doing is just remove just a little bit more of the root ball on that side. Just so we can get a little bit closer to the edge of the pot on that left hand side. Okay, just notice the roots have just started to dry out there, so if needs be,
got a spraz nearby. Okay, let's just have a little look in the pot. Okay, it's going to give us just that extra little bit of space on the right hand side there, so I think we're good to go. Just trim the surface a little bit more. Okay, this nice surface root just starting to show there. So I'm going to be looking to make the soil level so that that's going to be visible. So, let's prepare this pot. So I'm going to cut the mesh so that it's got about 15% extra on all sides. If it's too big, it's going to trap too much dust and soil underneath it. If it's too small, when you come to pull it tight, you could end up pulling the ends of the mesh up and allowing soil in underneath. Okay, so thinking that's a little bit on the large side, we're just going to trim the edges so it sits nicely against the curved edge of the pot there. Okay, that was a bit big on that side, unfortunately. Just cut the edges off there. That's nice and smooth against that. Okay, good. Right. This is some offcut of wire, aluminium wire. 1.5mm probably. I'm terrible at what the sizes. It's going to be strong enough to hold that in. And all I do is make a little staple like structure like this, okay, which is the same width as the hole. Okay, I'm gonna make two like that. Okay, and then feed them through like this. Okay, so what I'll do from this side is push ever so slightly and then fold over on that side. Okay, just trim the edges there. Okay, and that should be solid. So I'm pulling on that quite strongly, but it's not moving. Okay, so I'll do that again. Hold it over the centre. Through the edges, got to make sure that the edges, the legs of the staple are up against the edge of the pot. Okay, so I'm pushing from this side, but not so much so that the mesh is sort of being pulled up on that side. Turn it over, bend them. Okay, now if the holes were a little bit more sort of central, wouldn't need to worry too much about cutting the legs as short as we can. This is more an aesthetic thing than anything technical. Okay, there we go. Now, because the holes are almost flush, there's very little sort of depression in there. It's very, very slight. Just have to be careful that the pot is going to sit smooth and flush on the bench. Okay. So we cut that too short. There we go. Okay, so this wire that I chose, big thick gauge there, is going to be far too thick. If I put that on the bottom, when we lock, okay, that's going to be sort of sitting proud of the surface.
and cause the pot to wobble. So I'm going to have to go for a slightly smaller gauge wire. So this is 1.5 mil, I would think. I would say, yeah, 1.5 mil. Okay, which is usually, I would say, too thin for tying the trees in. Okay, so we're going to want about this sort of length. Okay, once. Come twice, measure. So it's not too short, not too long. Okay, and we'll feed it through on the inside. So tight up against the wall of the pot. Okay, for thicker wire, always kind of pre-bend. Okay, but because this is very thin wire, we can just feed it through, make sure it's nice and tight and snug. Okay, we'll push them to one side, and then just bend the legs towards each other so that we know which ones are connected to which. Okay, and then so what we'll do is we'll go on the other side. So we're going through the same hole, as good as. Okay, so again, feed it through. Normally, you'd always want to be thinking about how easy it is to tie. Okay, so these two. No, it's two short ends at one, two long ends at the other end. So what we'll be doing is tying both of them at this one point. So do think about where you're going to put your wires, how you're going to tie the tree. And always have two, if not three. For a tree like this, which has got a big established root ball, two wires should be enough. Now normally I would say go for a thicker gauge wire than this, but because of the pot situation here, we need to go as thin as possible. Okay, so we're ready to plant this in here. Okay, so put it in, get yourself a kind of an estimate of how much soil you're gonna need to put in at the bottom. Now, because this is quite a small pot, we're just gonna go with a shoting grain soil mixture that we've got here. Okay, we're not gonna put a drainage layer in the bottom. Just need to be, this should be large enough so that it doesn't go through the holes there. You can just check. So we are getting quite a bit of coming through. Okay, but not too much. So what we can do is just put a little bit of large particle soil over those. Right, so here's the large particle soil. Okay, basically the same mix, Akadama, pumice, lava, and Kiryu. So you can get the dust out. Not really very much, we only need to use a tiny little amount over the holes, okay, just to stop the smaller size going through. The reason why we want to try and use as much smaller size as possible is that it holds a lot more moisture. Okay, develop a lot finer root system. Okay, so take a big scoop of that. Okay. That's a very important stage because without doing that, you're just going to plug up the drainage holes, plug up all of the pores, spaces in between the soil, and cause issues for the tree in the future. Okay, so just have to check if the root ball is nice and flat underneath. Okay, there's no undulations, there's no gaps, no holes or anything like that, so we can just have a fairly flat root ball there, a fairly flat sort of surface layer of soil in there. Okay, just check for the pot, there's no damage on it. Okay, see a little bit of damage there, which is why that's going towards the back. Okay. So, seat the tree on the soil, see that it's quite high on this side. Okay, so just move it around a little bit, not too much. Okay, you want it slightly high in the pot. Okay, for an aesthetic perspective, we want it just a little bit extra height there. Now this is quite low on this side. The tree's sort of sinking down, so what we're gonna do, add some extra soil on this side. Okay. Just change it so that the tree's then moving up. Okay. I'm quite a fan of slightly higher plantings in the pot, so I don't mind. I don't feel that you have to have the soil level down to here and sort of cover all of those, all of the Navara and everything that's in there. Okay. That height that's underneath there gives it a little bit of elegance, so we're looking at accentuating that. Okay, now we don't want to go with this the wire across all of these surface roots there, so we're going to want to try and go across the edge of the root ball. Now, if we're not careful, this could slip off here. Okay, so what we can do is with our disposable chopstick, bamboo chopstick, just push it in there. That's what the hammer's for if it needs to be. Okay, and rubber mallet, so if we miss, we don't smash our pot. Okay, when you're doing this, just be careful that the tree isn't moving within the pot. Okay, that's in solid, you know, far enough. It's just to use something to catch onto so that it doesn't slip. Okay, we can go around the other side. Okay, and put it somewhere there. Okay, and then just tie it loosely on the one side. Okay, before going round and doing it on the other. Okay, so just make sure that's, so we don't need the chopstick there because that's hooked over the root ball nicely enough. We've planted it ever so slightly back in the pot. Okay, so then we have more root ball on this side. Okay, so that can come across there. And we can tie here. Okay. Gosh. The other tool that I forgot. Okay, so we're going to tie the wire in. Now this is very thin wire, okay, so I've got to be careful not to pull on too hard. Okay, so what we do is holding the root ball in position, just look at pulling the tension in the wire, making sure it's nice and tight. We don't want to, particularly with the thinner wire, we don't want it to be cutting like a tube wire through the roots. Okay, so just pulling the tension through, and we stop pulling, twisting clockwise. Okay, that should be plenty enough. Okay, a lot of people pull too hard, or pull and twist at the same time, which is what, why the wire is at the break. Do the same there. Okay, just give it a test, hold the pot, move it. Okay, there's a little bit of wobble there, but once we get soil in it all the way around, that's going to be nice and solid. Okay, so we'll just cut the ends of the wire there. Okay, and we can also cut the end, the bamboo chopsticks, just leaving a small amount. Okay, get it as flush as we possibly can, but still leaving enough of it there that the wire is going to hold on to it. Okay, and then the other end. Yeah. Okay. And then we fill up the soil, pour that on, all around. Okay, and then with our slightly larger dibber chopstick, work it in and around the root ball. Okay, the soil underneath, so we don't need to go in there and start pushing too much soil underneath there. Okay, that's going to disturb the root ball, move it around within the pot. Okay. But we need to make sure that all the gaps are filled in. Okay, you can work this too much and turn all the soil to dust. Okay. More in there. Work it around the edges, okay. If needs be, get yourself another chopstick. Smaller one. Okay, smaller chopstick to work in the tighter areas. Okay. Now, if we work it in too much, what will end up happening is the smaller particles, of which there's quite a bit of smaller particle pumice in here, will work, will get worked all the way down to the bottom, the larger particles rise to the top, and so we get uneven distribution. And then it's like a, that'll just end up with different areas of oxygen and different areas of water within the pot. Okay. Consistency is the key. We want all of that to be nice and consistent the whole way through. Okay, so we start getting a little bit of resistance. Okay, there's plenty of soil in there. We just don't, we don't want to be pouring it in and crushing it. Okay, so just brush the excess soil off, okay, and then water it in, then apply some top dressing of sphagnum moss, and then we'll have a look at the top of the tree. Okay, remember there was a, that big sort of gap in there, which is what the soil's in there for. Okay, where's that bloody choice? So that's fine in there, there's no gaps, just a little pool of fresh acadine. Okay, so get that watered.
Okay, so we've done that. So a bit of top dressing with sphagnum and moss. So that's chopped up sphagnum and chopped up green moss, various different varieties of it. We'll just sprinkle that lightly on the surface. Okay, it's had all the dust and the crap taken out of it when it's grated up, and so that won't get all kind of like clogged in and go through the holes that clog up the soil surface too much, and hopefully it'll not develop a nice surface layer of decorative green moss whilst at the same time just protecting, keeping moisture in that sort of important top layer of soil over the coming important kind of like coming few weeks. Okay, so that's pretty much the repot done. Now we can just look at the sort of the starting of the tree a little bit.
Bit of a change of plan from my initial thoughts of making the tree go towards the left hand side. The tree's now very much moving across towards the right, okay. And so, definitely, what we need to do is to remove this long leggy branch that's down here, okay. That's not doing anybody any favours, okay. So, we'll cut that off at the base, okay. And that's going to transform the feel of the whole tree, okay. As will the removal of this one in here. It's kind of all very, very sort of close in line with the kind of like almost like this second trunk like branch, okay. And so we're going to remove that, and that's going to clarify. There is quite a bit of green on it. There's a few secondary branches that are growing off of it, but not too much. Okay, but that's going to simplify and clarify that whole area up there. Okay, so it's going to look a little bit nicer. Then the other thing to think about is this branch at the back. Okay, it's quite low. Okay, it's also coming from essentially the same position as this one. So are we going to get some inverse taper in that area over time? Okay, I mean, we're talking sort of 15 years down the line. Okay, and also with the surface roots there, are we looking at potentially changing the front, just rotating around ever so slightly, in which case that one's not becoming a back branch, it's more becoming a kind of a, you know, it's definitely going to sort of be seen in this space that we're looking to accentuate and to highlight. Okay, so let's get rid of this one. I don't like the lower branches too much on trees. That's some nice elegance to it. Okay, keep these cut branches just to one side, just so we know, got an idea of how much has been removed from it. We don't even want a gin there. Okay, so let's get rid of that entirely. Okay, so I'm going to hold the tree, because remember it's not in the pot tight and securely. Okay, that can be cleaned up at a later date. Okay, now we just want to remove, there's a few of the branches that are coming towards us, some of these longer leggy branches, just so that we can see into the tree a little bit more, see the structure. Sorry, my head's in the way. Okay, so I'm just looking for areas that are a little bit too strong, that are coming out a little bit too aggressively towards the viewer. See if there's any areas that I can cut back to. Okay, thin things down a little bit, branches that are growing a little bit too vertically in this area. Okay, so looking at sort of defining that pad there is slightly lower. Okay, I'm gonna come in, there's one branch here. If you can see that. So we're looking at making this branch come out a little bit more horizontally rather than vertically. So it comes upwards and outwards, and then suddenly it's very vertically here. Check, see if you can see that. Okay, so that vertical bit gets taken off and we're looking at the outwards rather than the upwards. Okay, now we are starting to reduce the foliage quite a lot. Okay, but holding it back on this side is helping the movement across towards the right-hand side. So we're really just restricting that right-hand side, the left-hand side. Okay, we can look at just manipulating that branch down there. So we've got some foliage out of the back, that will help. Okay, this bit there is just a little bit strong. Where can we cut it back to? Okay, cut all the way back into there. And that's about enough, really, for the time being. If we take too much off the tree, then it's not going to be able to regenerate enough energy to generate enough energy to grow to help the roots. Okay, so cutting back the top and the bottom of the tree at the same time, never a good idea. Too aggressively, should we say. Okay. You know, if I'd have just left all of the foliage on here just for that reason, then we are losing some time in the development stage of the top of the tree. Okay, so about finding that nice balance. Okay, so we've taken off about less than a quarter of the foliage, I would say. Okay, and so there's still plenty of the tree there. Okay, so that's about it, really. Okay, so in the future, what we'll look at doing, once it's over the repot, we'll look at taking off some of these branches across here or dropping them down, bring them across there, open all of that up. Okay.
So the aftercare for a tree that's just been repotted like this would be to make sure it gets placed somewhere where there are no extreme conditions, particularly the wind and especially the cold. So like a polytunnel or greenhouse is ideal, and to not overwater it until it starts to take up water by itself. Okay, so keep it moist but not soaking wet.